Hey, boy, I gotta touch your partition of the game, bro.
Yes, yes, son.
You children back school with me. All right, Bradford from St. Lucie. So one time, Roy Bradford was part of the political platform. He said, ladies and gentlemen, they got a certain man down here that because he support the other side, he feel that he can do as he like, right? And he got a flock of cows walking through people garden, eating down all the ground provision. And Billy Miller said, not a flock, Roy, you heard her. He said, woman, don't tell me what the hell he heard. I'm telling you what he saw in my own two eyes.
And the cat, you know, the Guyanese are all about Barbados now. Working, some legal,
yeah.
A lot legal, and I get David Thompson get rid of most of the legal ones. But a lot of Guyanese fella working at Gordon's supermarket. A man coming, a big, tall, dark fella. Boss man, I need a hog head. Bono, we don't. I know the man said he want a half a hog head. He said, Bono, we don't sell half a hog head. You had to buy the whole thing, Bono. He said, man, but I just want to make a little sauce for me and the family. I want a whole one. I just want a half. Bono, we don't sell no. And half a hog head. The man said, man, you can ask the supervisor. I said, man, supervisor till in the back of the supermarket. Bano, I can't go down there, no. He said, as a customer. Okay, Bano, hold on. And he gone in the back of the suit. Boss, they got a big black ignorant bitch up there. Want a half a hog head. And the boss didn't respond at all. The boss just looking past him. So he realized after a while that somebody behind him, when he looked back, you see the big man behind me? He and this gentleman was like the other half. So later down in the week, the supervisor sent a colleague. He said, listen, I like how you get yourself out of trouble there the other day. You know, that was very quick, man. You can think on your feet. Where you from? Bano, I'm from Guyana. He said, what are you doing in Barbados? Bano, they have nothing in Guyana. All they have in Guyana, the horse and cricketers. The supervisor hollered, but my wife is Guyanese. He hollered, what's her batting average? Listen, boy. A boy from St. Andrew went in and studied for 5 years and come out home in the village in the nighttime, gone by the shop to see the boys that you see for the longest while. Man, Jesus, Harold? Man, wait. You got your degree? With honors. What were you study? Ventriloquism. Man, how do you show you ventriloquism? He said, well, is the art of making, of throwing your voice. You know, you can make it sound like the man over there talking when it's really me. You went for 5 years to study that. Man got a degree in medicine and law. You study what? What? Ventriloquism. So they made light of it and they said, man, don't worry about that. We drink some drinks. The next morning, Harry Gavin got going to look now for the man that on a farm that he used to talk to when he was a little boy. And the man always encouraged him to study and think, you know. Mr. Clark, back. Clarky Hall, man. Everybody, we hear that you come back yesterday, man. I'm glad to see you. You get through your study? Yes, sir. He studied ventriloquism. Clarky Hall, that sounds very big. That sounds like saying important, man. What's that? He says, the art of throwing my voice, man. Making it think like my voice over there, man. It's really me. Clarky Hall, I ain't understand. Hold on, let me show you. And the dog passed. He hollered, dog. Has Mr. Clark been good to you? The dog hollered, yes. Clarky Hall, what kind of magic that is? He says, not magic, it's ventriloquism. He says, dog, what does Mr. Clark do for him? He makes sure he get 3 square meals a day. And upon the evening, I lay down under that dump tree there so it is shade and he don't bother me. And it's got water all day long. So I think Clarky confused. Harry Hall, you don't believe it? He says, no, that's a magic. You're doing this, some kind of trick. He Hall, watch this. Horse, does Mr. Clark treat you well? As get hair all day? Man, just make sure I eat properly. I just get a little trot up when he passed out there and thing. Water all day long, treat me well. And sometimes bring in a little mirror from the other farm and let's fix up. So Clarky is totally confused. You see, you understand yet, Clarky? Clarky, hold on, man. No, this, you know this is a trick. The man hold a sheep. Come here. Clarky, hold that sheep just terrorizes it.
Everybody
know about Herman, right?
No.
Have you ever told about Herman?
No.
Herman's a fella that ain't too bright, right? One day Herman's coming on highway 2A from the direction of Mile and a Quarter, heading towards Warren's, and doing big numbers. Motorcycle cop on behind the man and pull you over. But you know, the cop to take the time to park the motorcycle and walk right slowly to Herman.
Yeah.
I said, "Miss sir, let me see your license, please." Herman, I'm not going to make up one of mine, you know, I want to take it away last week.
Jesus Christ.
Herman wanted to hit off on the highway there by Trimark, Haggett Hall. As soon as he hit the highway, the cell phone rang. He looked at it and sees his wife. "Hello, girl, I told you, do not call me when I'm driving." "She only called you because I had a news flash from VOB." "What is it?" "They got a man driving the wrong way on the highway, be careful." Herman hollered, "A man? All of them driving." Herman told me personally that he's the best domino player in the world and second best in the Caribbean.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
And then he tell me he would like to try this suicide bombing thing once or twice. And then retire. A fella from the Bayland gone in Swan Street looking for work. You going with this Indian man. "Skipper, are you looking for work? You have any vacancies?" Indian man said, "Oh, I'm glad to see little boy look for job, eh? But I don't have vacancy, things slow by." He said, "Well, I just want to listen, you know, keep out of trouble." "Oh," the Indian man said, "you can sell?" He said, "I mean, if I can sell." Somebody called for a pack of cigarettes, you get him a pack of cigarettes. Indian man said, "You don't sell, so, eh? But I'm glad to see little boy looking for job. You could start now." Boy, somebody comes, I come down to work. He said, "Okay, start now." Just as the father start, a woman come to the door. The Indian man said, "Little boy, watch and see how you sell. Watch carefully. Madam, can I help you?" She said, "I know about a big house up in Kingsland. And I want to start a lawn. I hear you got all kind of seeds in here for lawns. I have plenty of variety. Come." And I went through for 15 minutes. She shows you all different kinds of seeds for lawn. She picked the one she want. Indian man looked back, little boy, and winked. He says, "Madam, now that you buy seed for the lawn, you want to invest in lawnmower?" She said, "Well, Jesus Christ, why I'm going to lawn yet? What are you going to do with a lawnmower?" He said, "Ah, VAT coming, huh? Lawnmower 253 now. When VAT come, lawnmower 364. She said, "You better give me the lawnmower now." He said, "Ah, you see?" And he said, she gone along. He said, "Little boy, you see how you sell? Sell two things, not one. Somebody called for a pack of cigarettes, sell cigarette and matches. Two things." Little boy hold up, "Okay, you understand." And a man comes to the door looking a little sheepish, you know, like. He said, "Let me see you sell this now." He gone to the man, "Skipper, can I help you?" The man lowered his voice. He said, "I would like to buy some pads for the madam, you know?"
This time, man.
He said, "Man, you don't got to talk this off, man. Everybody know about pads, man. We got, look. We got Tampax. We got this thing. We got more this. And come all the way down. Always." The man hollered, "All right, give me the Tampax." He looked back at the Indian man, all right? He says, "Skipper, now that you buy the Tampax, I can interest you in a lawnmower." He mahala, "What the fuck a lawnmower got to do with pads?" And the little boy held away from the looks of it. "You ain't got enough pussy this weekend, so you might as well cut the fucking grass."